As of July 13th of 2025, there are currently 46 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is the same number as were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes is Hawaii's famed Kilauea volcano, which once again this week produced a series of more than 1,000 foot high stunning lava fountains. These fountains specifically occurred on July 9th, reaching maximum heights of 365 meters or 1,198 feet across an episode of activity, which lasted for just under 9 hours. This marks Kilauea's 28th cyclical episode since December 23rd of 2024, with another such episode, in my opinion, likely to begin between July 15th and July 21st. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Indonesia, a major explosive eruption occurred at the Lewotobi volcano, causing multiple square miles of ground to be incinerated by pyroclastic flows and generating a more than 70,000-foot-high eruption column. Meanwhile, in Iceland, increased earthquakes at the Katla volcano seemingly signaled the generation of a glacial flood termed a jökulhlaup. And in what is this week's top story, an unusually strong earthquake swarm struck what is, in my opinion, the Pacific Northwest's most potentially dangerous volcano, Mount Rainier. This earthquake swarm began in the very early morning hours of July 8th when, at 1:29 a.m., a series of small earthquakes struck underneath its summit, occurring one after the other in rapid succession. Sometimes, even multiple quakes occurred in a single minute. These earthquakes did not follow the decreasing trend expected for a single aftershock sequence, instead representing a true earthquake swarm. While this swarm would decline over time after its first 24 hours, it is still ongoing, so far involving more than 500 earthquakes. This is the single strongest earthquake swarm Mount Rainier has experienced in at least 36 years, as sufficient monitoring equipment that was capable of detecting most negative magnitude earthquakes has only been on the volcano since 1989. Yet, none of these quakes were large enough to be felt by even individuals standing right above their epicenter. As, with only three exceptions, every single event represented a micro-earthquake, with only three quakes greater than magnitude 2.0. So, should people panic due to this unusually strong earthquake swarm? Absolutely not. There's zero evidence that this earthquake swarm has a magmatic origin, or is even due to a form of volcanic unrest. Supporting my assertion, there's been no volcanic tremor, no increased gas emissions, no change in tilt meter readings, and no new or existing ground deformation. Every important reading at the volcano is normal, so there's nothing to worry about. As, just like Rainier's prior earthquake swarm in 2009, the culprit had to do with fluid movement, in this case, water. You see, meltwater from the volcano's melting glaciers, general regional precipitation, and groundwater combine and interact with the volcano's hydrothermal system. Due to the deep heat from magma, this can heat the aforementioned water, causing it to rise, and during this process, these fluids may interact with regional faults. This lubricates them, making it easier for the faults to slip and generate an earthquake. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, the laki-laki cone of the Lewotobi volcano produced its largest eruption on record on July 7th. On that day, building pressure beneath the plug that had formed under its summit was violently released at 11:05 a.m., generating a large volcanic explosion that caused a plume of ash to rapidly rise to an altitude of 22,200 meters or 72,835 feet. Thereafter, a subplanean eruption began, with a sustained plume of ash rising to an altitude of 15 kilometers that then drifted to the west. Then, hundreds of thousands of gas-rich volcanic rock fragments carried high into the plume began raining down on multiple towns up to 13 kilometers away, with some more than softball-sized fragments coating the ground. The eruption continued for another two full hours, and by the time it had ended, nearly 13.85 square kilometers or 5.35 square miles surrounding the volcano had been incinerated, with pyroclastic flows traveling up to 4,500 meters away from Laki-Laki's summit, largely to the northeast. And, in Iceland, the cause of a false uplift signal and an elevated number of earthquakes at the nation's most consistently explosive Holocene volcano was revealed. As, beneath the Katla volcano, meltwater was on the move, presumably due to increased fumarolic temperatures in one of its geothermal areas, and this resulted in a small jökulhlaup on the Skolmar River. This jökulhlaup peaked on July 10th at about double the river's normal discharge rate and is already decreasing, marking the volcano's second glacial flood in only 2 years. And now, here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on July 12th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.